If there is no love, we won't do anything that is worthy of being done.
My son watching TV, when he only hear Maria open the door to come and take his breakfast, he run and take his bread. They say, no, and they will fight for a bread.
West Coast, we have a Mara Mote, West Coast, Badina Mirenton, okay, in a Moti, Langaban.
If you don't know about West Coast, it starts from Mirenton all the way to Langaban.
You saw Tozaliko Sangisaba, Congolese volunteer, for Bazalina Mirenton, Danu, Rubek, West Mirenton.
Anything that we have to know. In our conference that we organized, a unique conference that we had. She was like part of the youth.
I remember those times the church was very small. I called Sister Rumbi and Sister Suzanne, go see Maria. But it was not enough because she was alone at home. She was in summer green, mean parklands. I said, I cannot come every day to take care of you. I took Maria to my place, is when the bond started become mother and daughter. She was really
give and take away. My heart we choose to say, Lord, blessed be the name.
is too just to be questioned. God is too good to be wrong. God knows what is the best for each one of us. In Job chapter 1, verse 18 to 22, when Job lost his children, he stood up, tore his robe, and shaved his head. Then he fell down and worshiped God by saying, God gave and God has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Let us imitate Job by blessing the name of God when we go through the season of weeping like this. 2 Samuel chapter 12, verse 16 to 20, the Bible said that David prayed and fasted 7 days so that God would heal his son. But after receiving news that his son passed away, David stopped crying. He arose from the ground, washed, anointed himself. He changed his clothes and went into the house of the Lord to worship him. This is another good example of how we should overcome the feelings of the flesh and put our trust, confidence, and the faith in God alone. John 11, verse 35. Jesus wept at the tomb of Lazarus, but he lifted up his eyes to heaven while weeping, and he said, Father, I thank you. We weep because death seems to be an affair. We will not see the face of our sister for a while. We will not enjoy a smile for a while. I will not enjoy a coffee and avocado that you are doing for me every day in the office. Verse 7, the Bible says God sees our tears the same way he saw the tears of people of Israel. God sees our tears. He knows what we are going through. God sees the sufferings and hears the cry of his people. God never changes. God is faithful. God is just, and God still loves us no matter what we may go through. Yes. And John 14, verse 1, the Bible says, Jesus says to the people, let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. I am going to prepare a place for you. Verse 3. I will come again and receive you to myself, that where I am, there you may be also. Verse 5. I am the way, Jesus said, the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. Our sister was born again. By the time we are with you, she is in paradise, enjoying the goodness of the Lord. Let me finish by giving you this. In 1 Thessalonians chapter 4 verse 16, the Bible says, "For the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ will arise first. Then we who are alive and remain will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. So we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, comfort one another with this word." My main question is for you to ask yourself, where will you spend your eternity? Have you already given your life to Jesus Christ? There is no salvation, there is no eternal life if you have not given your life to Jesus Christ. We don't want you one day to cry like that man rich was crying to Abraham and said to him, "Send Lazarus to help me with water because there is a fire where I am." And Abraham told him, "There's no way that someone from you can come here, or someone from us can reach you." And he said, "Please send Lazarus to my father's house so that he can tell them to change their behavior, to change their way of living, and to receive Jesus Christ." But the Bible says, Abraham answers, "They have prophets, they have evangelists, they have pastors. They must listen to them." And this afternoon, as I'm finishing, I would like to give you just 1 minute to think about your life. If you have not yet take a decision to receive Jesus Christ in your life, if you have not yet done it, this is the moment. In your heart, just say, "Lord Jesus, I thank you for your word. I take a decision to invite you as my Lord and Savior." Lift up your voice and pray where you are.
Say a few words on the life and the biography of our departed sister Maria. Maria Yulenga was born on the 28th of October 1978 in Lusaka, Zambia. She was the second born of the in the family of two, the child of Jenala Machila and Crispin Mulenda, who are both deceased and with the Lord. She grew up in Lusaka, where she attended St. Patrick's Primary School from grade 1 to grade 7, and proceeded to Sikaronga High School, where she did a grade 8 to grade 12, and got her matric. She further proceeded to Evelyn Hwang College, where she obtained her tertiary qualification in accountancy. Maria had a very big heart, and because of that heart and compassion for others, she was compelled to adopt the child of her late brother, who was only 6 years old when the father passed on. She kept him under her custody for 14 years and the child is now 20. And that child knew Maria as her mother. Maria was married to Honke, Honka, and she survived by two kids, Chloe and Ashley. Family expresses themselves and say, as a family, we have lost a friend, a mother, an aunt, and a pillar in our family. During her visit to Zambia with her children in November 2020 to 2021, the family had a great time with Maria. Last, they spoke with Maria on the phone during the last hours. They actually learned of the illness of the late Maria on the 22nd of January 2024. When unfortunately she answered the Lord's calling on the 23rd of January 2024 at around 2 p.m. As Christians, we believe that we will meet her again when the Lord Jesus Christ comes. On behalf of all mourners, well wishers, the Congolese family, the Zambians here in the Western Cape, the pastor and the church, we thank you all for coming to mourn our sister. And again I say to Maria, fly high, my sister, until we meet again. Thank you.
Now I'm going to call some people for testimonial, and the first person is Brother Jonathan, while Mama Odile is getting ready. Brother Jonathan.
Good afternoon, church. Good afternoon, everyone. It's very sad to see that the whole room is wearing black this afternoon. And it's very sad that we all are mourning our beloved sister that we love so much. So I'll just speak about her on behalf of the church. Sister Maria Mulenga joined the church from the beginning of the ministry, 2012, and has been a faithful servant since then. Her faithfulness was not only limited to spirituality, but also extended to the financial side and in all her services that she rendered to the Lord through the church. She served as an usher in the church, and she became the leader of the usher for some years and joined the praise and worship team where she served the Lord wholeheartedly. During her last days on earth, she served as an admin in the church and still served in other departments in praise and worship, in ushering, and also in prayer leading. She was always ready to assist departments, and her coordination of the church department was done with love, passion, and devotion to the Lord. On several occasions, she cleaned the house of the Lord alone and did not wait to form a team to have the house of God clean. Everyone has a good story to tell about somebody. Everyone has a good story to tell about her. I remember when my wife arrived, she said, I will drive your wife when she arrived here. There are friends that attended the youth ministry who are not part of Philip Generation Ministries. But every time they came, and even though they were away, they would always ask, how is the church? How is Sister Maria? She was a person with a big heart to support everyone. She was more than a big sister to many of us. Every time she would come to us and speak and say, Jonathan, what you are doing is the right way. And I want you to inspire as many people as possible to become people in life who will find that in another person, if it's not a big sister or mother. I remember, I'm not saying this because I know that in the gasket she's not there anymore. Like Papa said just now, she's somewhere better. So I remember when she was still alive, I spoke to her. The last call that I had with her, I arrived to church on a Sunday morning and I parked my car outside. I was with my wife. So while we were waiting for the gate to be open, the gate was still closed. Then I called her. That was after a few days she was not in church because of her illness. So I told her one thing. I said, Sister Maria, I can see that you are really missed. Because I've come to church and I'm at the gate is still closed. And she said to me, I do not have the keys on me, should I come and open? I told her, I'm not calling you to come and open the church, but I'm calling to tell you how important you've been to the ministry and to the church. She has been an inspiration to this church. As the leader of the youth, every time we had organization, she made sure that the church is ready for anything that we have to do. In our conference that we organized, the unique conference that we had, she was like part of the youth, running around with us and making sure that everything went well. We are not crying or mourning about a servant who passed on. We are mourning about a person who had the heart that everyone should imitate. As the Bible says in the book of Hebrews, that imitate those who through faith and patience inherit the promises of God. Since the Lord allowed it that she can rest now, that the Lord Jesus has not yet returned, we believe as Christian, and we believe in the church, Philip Generation Ministries, and all its branches, that our Sister Maria will rise first when the Lord Jesus Christ shall return to meet him in the sky. God bless you.
Thank you, Mama. Rebecca is getting ready.
Is with a heart broken, I can say some things about Maria. Today I'm saying goodbye not to the member of the church, I'm saying goodbye to a daughter. She's really a daughter to me. She was a daughter to me. Like everybody say, Maria joined the church at the beginning. There is certain people, if they die, you feel like something in you is leaving you. I feel like something in me is going with Maria. Why? Because Maria was my daughter. When she joined the church, sometimes she gets sick. I remember those times the church was very small. I called Sister Mumbi and Sister Suzanne, go see Maria. But it was not enough because she was alone at home. She was in summer green, mean parklands. I said, I cannot come every day to take care of you. I took Maria to my place is when the bonds start become mother and daughter. She was really a daughter. I remember those days, Maria and my son, there was just, if Maria was sleeping, my son watching TV, when he only hear Maria open the door to come and take his breakfast, he'll run and take his bread. I said, no, auntie, don't fight for a bread. It means my son have a big sister he didn't have. Maria was there. I know, even if I'm not planning, I know she'll do some things I'll forget. Like everybody say, you'll feel the presence of Maria when you're at church. She was everywhere, every department. It's heartbroken to see her going too soon. But what I know, I'll meet Maria again. She's somewhere resting. I know member of the church, of the family of Maria. She used to tell me about Apea. Auntie Brenda, I never saw them. But I know a part of their family. I never spoke to them, but I know them. Why? Because she took me as a mother. Sometimes she said she became too possessive of my husband. I always say to her, you are pastor's daughter. I'm sure even if I will not make breakfast for spent, but when you reach the church, Maria will make some things. And God made me go with Maria every step of the way. When she got pregnant of Chloe, Chloe used to call me a granny. For Maria to go to work, she'll bring Chloe at my place. The husband said, go take Chloe at the crèche. She will say, Chloe will be safe with Mama Pastor. Bokeri came, Ashley came. Today I know the family of Bokeri to Maria. I'm close to family of Bokeri to Maria. I know people from Zambia to Maria. People who are not with us in the church, they came because Maria was part of each and everyone's life. She can have a witness, like everybody say, she has a good heart. Heart of humbleness. When she got pregnant before paying the Lobola, she called me and said, I know Papa will be upset. Can you plead for Papa, for me? I know I disappoint him, but she humbled herself and went back to his father, and they became again father and daughter. Maria, I know you are not with us, but those who are with us, just prepare your way. Just one day before Maria departure, I came to church. My heart just said, go and see Maria, and it was the last day. I just bathed her, I cooked for her that day. And she said, Mama, I want you to cook something. I was cooking something and I received just because she's not responding. You know, sometimes when they say she's not, I say, what do you mean by she's not responding? Because I did not expect death to come soon. I know she was sick. I was believing, trusting God, she's going to recover. But God loves her more than me. And God, take Maria from us. Your way. Death doesn't tell you how to come which day, but be ready. Anytime death will come. Thank you. And see you again.
I'm calling Mama Rebecca while Mr. Marco is getting ready.
In times of storm, can we sing together? Father, you are King. I am God. Be still.
We are not crying as unbelievers. We have the hope that we are going to see him one day. Amen. So I came in 2018, coming from Johannesburg, when I came here for work, and God allows that I met Auntie Maria as Pastor Cornelius, and we became closer because we were staying in the same house. I've seen Maria growing, serving God. I've seen Maria giving birth. I've seen Maria become so mature in the things of God. He was everywhere. And even this morning when we were coming, I was telling Pastor in the car, when Sister Maria is in the church, you know that she's here, because you find the church clean. You find the church, the doors are open. You find everything ready for the service. And if it was to redeem or to ransom someone from not dying because of the service, Sister Maria was not going to die. If it was for the service, God was going to spare the life.
Yes.
He was serving even when it was not well with her. I remember on the Christmas day, it was the 31st. She was weak. I was with her at the back. We were busy feeding people because we were sharing food and all that. Suddenly she told me that, Mama, I'm tired. I cannot anymore. I want to sit down. Say, okay, just sit down. But even at the last minute, she was hoping, she was serving, she was pushing. In faith, she was pushing, hoping that it's gonna be otherwise. But thank be to God who decided otherwise. Amen.
Amen.
And today is going to rest. I know today is in the better place. We are crying because we used to see her. We are crying because in the physical, we are not going to see her anymore. But we know one day we will see her again. We will see her again. To Papa Bukeri, take heart. Those two children, they are looking up to you. Sister Maria was the one praying, you know, showing the ways of God. Now be the priest of the house. Those children need the God of your wife. Let no man tell you anything. God is able to do exceedingly abundantly and above. He can touch where anyone can. We can talk, we can cry, but there is no one who can feel the pain and who can touch your heart except God himself. So to the entire church, thank you for coming, and let's keep on, you know, supporting them. And above all, be ready. Above all, be ready. Yesterday something happened. It was load shedding. and I was in my room just about the balcony at 11:30. I just started praying. 2 minutes was too much. There was a very, very bad accident and people died on the spot. There, in front of my house. The car, how can you, a car coming from this side, jump to go in the complex? And in that complex, there was those robbers who always, you know, sleep. The car even went to attack the innocent robbers who were sleeping. Anything can happen. Life is too short. Do not hold grudges. You have a problem with your neighbor, with your brother, with your sister. Make peace, because you never know when will be your turn. God bless you.
Amen.
Sorry, congregation. I would like to speak to Lingala because I was mandated by the family to speak on their behalf. So someone will interpret and translate. So my message will go to the mother of Bong, auntie, uncle, and all the family. Are you ready?
Yes.
Are you ready for that?
Yes.
Thank you. Mbote na bino lingomba.
I greet you all in the name of Jesus.
Na niko pesa bino botondi mi.
I want to thank you so much.
Ko ete nazali mandate na libota ya ndeko Bonke.
Because I received the mandate from the family of Brother Bonke.
Na na kongo ko ete ba tokoka kolobela.
They in Congo, in order for us to speak on their behalf here in South Africa. I'm not standing here just for the sake of standing, but I'm standing here with two positions. First, I am the uncle to Bonke,
grand frère,
his big brother,
community.
And secondly, I am the leader of the Congolese community. Just like I said, I am representing every Congolese in West Coast. I say thank you to you all. All the testimonials that we heard here, we all heard them. We have nothing more to add to our sister-in-law, Maria. I also want to thank our family-in-law that came all the way from Zambia to come and take the course. I thank them so much because we had a long discussion for some agreements and everything went well. So I say thank you for that.
Natondi, président ya communauté zambienne, na chairperson na ye po basala ki musala malam po na biso.
I thank the leader of the Zambian community and his chairperson because they did a great work for us. If we can all sit here as we're sitting, it's because of them that this is possible. And I thank all the Congolese community. I know that only few people came here because the message did not go to everyone that there was a funeral.
And
I'm sending a message to every Congolese that is in the West Coast.
Soki West Coast boyebi yango malamu te West Coast ebandi na Milenton okay na moti na Langaban.
If you don't know about West Coast, it starts from Milenton all the way to Langaban.
Biso tozali kosangisa ba Congolais volontaires o bazali na Milenton, Danu, Lubek, West Milenton. Sorry, Milenton, Lubek, Danu Fontaine, Tito Leki nanga Bumpanziwa.
So as we are actually gathering all the Congolese that are willing to join the community from Milton all the way to Langaban with all the areas in between.
Atlantis bazali deja na communauté parce que bango pe bazali na West Coast mais bazali deja na communauté o ezo ko diriger ba.
The only exception is on Atlantis because that area has got their own community that leading them.
Yango nazali ko senga pe ko encourager misu ba Congolais.
That's why I'm asking and encouraging all Congolese.
Il faut to sa la différence. 2024 ezali année de différence.
We need to make a difference because 2024 is a year of making a difference.
Pona ko sa la différence, il faut to za la bon moko.
And for that difference to happen, we need to be one. The word of God reminds us all the time that we dwell in love. If there is no love, we won't do anything that is worthy of being done. Love is God. The word of God says that with God we shall do great exploits.
Voilà pourquoi nous avons benga bandeko ba Congolais toye kolanda ndeko na biso bonka.
That's why I'm sending this message while we came to support our brother Bonka.
Leleza ndeko Bonka.
Today it's him. Tomorrow it can be me. And after tomorrow it might be you. But if we do not go into that, it's
going
to be very difficult for us. Other communities are mocking us. Stealing is not a bad thing.
Sorry.
Stealing is a very bad thing. But to copy is not a bad thing. We need to copy how other people from West Africa are doing. Because if we are at that level, we're not going to wait for the Zambian community to come and assist us.
Voilà, oh, une message à mon pousser na copé ça na communauté congolaise.
This is the short message that I wanted to give to the Congolese community.
Lisanga et kosa la biso différence.
Togetherness will make us become better.
Tokokende liboso kaka na lisanga.
We'll move together because of that union.
Ndeko Bonka tika lina bana.
My brother Bonka has got children. Today, if the corpse goes to the tomb, he will stay alone with the kids. We want to know where is the love of the Congolese community. I thank you so much. Thank you. This was the word to send to the country.
Thank you. I'd like just to ask Papa Bonke if you are able to speak. Let's talk to you soon. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone.
C'est plus que bon à Sanga, à Bananakolo, Katnelonga, à Tambe.
I'm happy to see the congregation of the children of God in the joy of the Lord.
Premièrement, on a dit, merci et Bananakolo, parce que la Bible nous dit, en circonstances, nous sommes bonnes.
First of all, I want to say thank you to God because the Bible says that in every circumstance we need to thank God.
Deuxièmement, Nazali, c'est la merci. Ma soutien à Patignon sort pour y soutenir qui libotanangaï moralement, physiquement, financièrement.
And secondly, I want to thank every person that contributed and supported my family spiritually, morally and financially in this hard time.
Troisièmement, nous allons kusenga merci mingi na ministère oyo batika kibiso te toujours na mabonde li bazala ki na biso ma molonga ni na tombe pasteur na biso Cornelius ami makamu nenge tokanda ki na ebande na maladi ya Martin Suka.
And thirdly, I would like to thank the whole church because in this hard time they've been by us and praying all the time. And I want to thank particularly the pastor of the house, Pastor Cornelius, who knows exactly how the sickness started and all the way to the end.
Sister Maria Moreno.
For those who do not know me, I'm the one who was married to Maria Moreno.
Nazo baksa jisusu, soki nazo yeba jisusu mkodo na kutana kana Maria Moreno. Ayebisa kingayi, lupa jiboso kwa ayebisa ngalubi, nazali mwasi na katina kolo.
So when I met Maria, one thing that she told me was that I am a child of God.
Nazali mingi ya kusepela ena yoki mwana na nzamba ebisi nazali moko kati na na nzambe.
I was very happy to hear that she told me that she was born again.
Tani ce que nous allons aller mettre fois d'ailleurs ça n'a photo ya na kati.
So when we met, she told me another thing that we need to start coming to church more often to pray.
The
Bible says that, like David said, that I was happy when they said to me, let us go to the house of the Lord. So even the days that I was tired, I did not move back because I kept on following Maria since she showed me the right way to follow, the way of the Lord.
So we are living because it is a testimony of my Maria, who is the Mother of the Lord, na kubenga batu na katina libota na kolo.
So this was a very great work that she did when she was alive, calling the people to come to the kingdom of God.
So kanalobolobaki Maria na vanda kina ya zalaki masi ya bolingo, zalaki masi ya peni kitis.
And lastly, I want to say that Maria was a submissive woman.
Maria abani maladi zalaki toujours
and when she was sick, I was still by her up until the end.
Maria, papa na mokumba oyo ezali awa ezali mokumba na yo parce que you never know.
Yeah, so okay, when I was giving her the bath, so she told me that this responsibility is yours.
So nazalaki na kondima te mokolo oyo nakomona Maria na kati ya cercueil.
I couldn't imagine that I would see Maria in a coffin today.
Nakomisi nzambe nayebi mwana nzambe soki akufi akufaka akendaka boye te molimo na ye ekendaka toujours pa ya epankolo na lolo.
I thank God because I know that when a child of God passes on, she goes to the better place in heaven. And I believe that Maria is in a better place with the Lord.
So
if I remember well and I can try to compare her to a Bible personage, I would say that Maria was working just like Ruth used to work.
Maria,
thanks so much. May Maria's soul rest in peace. The word you told me to be with the kids and to not get tired of keeping them. In my belief, I know that the Lord will give me enough wisdom to take this responsibility very well.
Mama Oyo, ezali Mama Oyo, ezali Mama, and so you should take care of Mama Oyo, ete abiso.
All of us in this time, all that is alive, we need to learn from what's happening.
Oyo bake mokili Oyo, ezali so you should, nous sommes des passagers.
We need to know that we are all passengers on earth. And we that are still alive, we need to know where to put our feet and how to walk. Thanks, I'm going to stop here.
Maria,
rest in peace, Maria. I will not forget about the good things you've done in my life. You've done a lot in your life, Maria. May the Lord be with you. The judgment of the Lord is always there. I will never forget you for my whole life. This flower that I'm giving you, it's not the last flowers.
You
know that the next time I will see you again, I will come with a flower.
Merci beaucoup. Vous avez dit frère ya bolingo. Vous êtes là qui monte ma bolingo.
Thanks so much. This out of love because you are a person full of love.
Merci beaucoup.
Thanks so much. May God bless you all.
Okay, thank you. This was the last testimony. I would like to call Pastor for the closing prayer. And in the meantime, can you help us call the undertaker so that after the prayer, we're going to open the coffin for the viewing. So I will direct you so that the movement of people can go as mostly. So Pastor.
I'd like to call Pastor Victor to come and close the prayer.
Can we please stand up and to close? Let's pray. Father Lord, we thank you. We bless you for this wonderful life. Well lived. And she ended the race successfully in the Lord. We thank you because she's by you right now. We thank you because the reward goes to this man, great man, who has taken care of Maria and his wife. We thank you for the husband and the children whom you have a plan, because you said, for you know the plans that you have for us, the plans to prosper us, the plans to give us future. And this plan, your children also found themselves within. As we closing this moment, we know that you have spoken to each heart in this place to understand that there is an end to each life. All of us will go through this journey where you will call us sooner or later. I pray, mighty God, that this remain engraved in the heart of each and every one of us. To live for you, to search for the kingdom. And when people look at us, the day you will take us, to remember that we've walked with you. I recommend to you all the logistics. I recommend to you everything that will follow from now on. Give glory to your name for the sake of your servant. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. In Jesus' mighty name we say, Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I'm going to call the undertaker. People at the back, you can come forward and we're going progressively.
until this.
Give and take away. My heart will choose to say, blessed be your name. I give and take away. Say, oh, blessed be your name. You give and take away. Give and take away. My heart will choose to say, oh, blessed be your name. Give and take away. Blessed be your name, blessed be the name of the Lord, blessed be the name, blessed be the name of the Lord, blessed be your glorious name, blessed be the name of the Lord, blessed be the name of the Lord, blessed be the name of the Lord, blessed be your glorious name. You give and take away, Lord, you give and take away. My heart we choose to say, oh, blessed be the name.
Choose. Abuya. Yeah. Ah, vous avez une bande mystique, hein?
Move your car there, my man. What's your problem? What do you mean to wait?
Yeah, they will bring it here.
I think
keep it.
You keep it.
It's fine.
You left already.
So yeah. You have to keep it. There you're gonna bring the body there and then
I think you will meet
you.
Where
you go, we can go with.
Oh, now, we're going to
yes?
Yeah,
the picture must. Directeur Silva, bonjour. Message à Néni, tu as dit que tout le monde s'est rabimi. Et bien, nous avons Zambie, nous avons habité la communauté de la Kiawa, en tout cas, qui nous a représenté en fort. Message à Néni.
Ah bon, message à Yumo, vous allez ici, vous allez au monde. Ils allaient vraiment ça au moment où il y a un passe pour soit qu'il ne soit à perdre. Moi, c'est ça avec la boutique a été mon communauté congolaise. Ils ont mené tout le monde. Tant au moment qu'on a vu ça, c'est problème pour assister toujours. On a vu ça tout de suite. Si les gens ont été bénis, on ne passe pas là, mais on devait quand même pour assister des points. À terminer, vous allez aller à Rokunda et à Zambie. Alors, vu ce bateau de Tikali, pour les gens, voilà, pour Fanda et puis pour Ibandeni, pour ça. On a aidé, il y a soit il y a une famille, il y a à part ça, nous allons.
Merci. Papa Titi, j'ai invité à Robaxe Zali, dans mon comité de la Kiawa. Je sais pas, un petit message na ndeko wa bungsi mwasi na famille et puis na communauté.
Eloko na kongo ba vraiment yaka kiawa support na bisu ko sa ki na dama na ko bi ke za existe sa patina na 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 quando on a vu son communauté complexe, on a vu son communauté. Moi, pour mon yango, ça fait mal. Mais quand on a vu son communauté, c'est ça. Quand il y a un mot, c'est vrai qu'il y a un mot. Même au service. La propre, c'est un peu qui. C'est peut-être lundi à mardi au Kenyozambi. Mais, quand même, c'est l'équipe qui vient. L'équipe vient. J'ai un peu de Tikalina.
Merci. Oliver, un message. Message à Néni. Moi, message n'est pas bon. Dans mon comité lobby, je ne sais pas.
C'est ça. Et donc, c'est Maraca, il y a le bosson à nous mettre en Zambie dans cette circonstance où il y a volonté en Zambie. Il y a mis balé à Nagopé Saraka, la condoléance, dans la famille Mumba, surtout dans Papa Boka. Et donc, on a aussi un courage. Courage de Gonangaï. Et ça facilite. Il y a un message à Nagopé. Et ça, il y a un message. Et vous avez des bandes, les amis, alors courage là, quand on a dit que les bananes sont sur Bazali, ils sont sur les cotorotiques, ils sont toujours pour nous consommer. Ils sont sur les cotorotiques, ils sont sur les cotorotiques, ils sont sur les
Ça va bien, ma bain. Ouais, non, mais tu n'as pas tu es là, tu es déjà dans ce matin. C'est là que tu peux te faire, tu n'as pas tu n'as
c'est bon.
Non, 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 non.
Even inside, when you just get in, what do you do?
You know what you do? You don't want to
do that. You don't want to do that. You don't want to do that. You don't want to do that.
Biso tozala na mode ya matanga, tozala matanga, moni yango tovai na se, po tozolela nano. Maire, totiki maire, tozalaki na service. Alors, tellement Bible ezo recommande biso tozala mingi, place oyo ya mawa, ke na place ya fete. Nde yango toye awa, tovani awa, na ndenge ya mawa, tolela na ndeko na biso bonkere. Madame Tigi Bisso, tellement que les corps ont été mis en place, ils 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 ont été mis en place, Batigala pena kimia. Yado de tasa tata bana oleka goya ko reconforter ndo na biso bonkere.
Bonkere bondeli afuta na
ma. Ya, mais to lobira ga nzamba pesagi, nzamba zui. Yo moko mettre ya tana ya circonstance. Merci.
Thank you. Champion, bonjour.
Ba condoléances mingi master nga bonkere en tout cas, on est ensemble. Toka kanga mutema zana mutema munene, zana ngaka. Ikutaka mtu nyoso. Tuka pole mingi na swahili na bi pole bi sorry makasi. Merci.
Je suis un peu plus de temps. To banda ki yango bien to silisa yango pe bien to songi silo kumwe pa nkolo e oyo etikali na baye bayaki na baye oyo esengeli baye après en tout cas to consoler ye azala fort na mutema na kawe ekomeli ye comme ça continuité ya bana ezala bien na makoko nyonso lokole leki bien esuka yango ne peut-être ka kolo baye. Merci vraiment pour la assistance na ba oyo nyonso ekomeli biso
to commercer monsieur Rolo Bezal. C'est bon, merci.
Thank you.
People at the back, you can come forward. We're going progressively until, please.
Give and take away. My heart will choose to say, blessed be your name. Give and take away. Give and take away. My heart will choose to say, Lord, blessed be your name. You give and take away. Give and take away. My heart will choose to say, Lord, blessed be your name.